Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamu alaikum, dear students. Let's start our lesson number 6. Today we will read two texts from OPE and number of nouns from grammar. Okay, let's take start from OPE nonfiction, page 19 to 25. The text at page 20 and 21 is actually two texts. You have to separate them. One is called The Orphan Elephant and the other is Candy Pereira. Read the text carefully and try to separate these two texts. At page 22 and 24, these texts have been separated for you. But first try yourself and then check whether you have done it correctly or not. It would be a fun for you. Okay? Let's read the first one at page 22, The Orphan Elephant. There are three paragraphs of this text. Let's read the paragraphs one by one. Listen carefully as you have to write the answers to the question given at the end. Paragraph 1. In this paragraph, we are told about a baby elephant who was standing alone in Pinnawala Elephant Orphanage in Sri Lanka. He was tied to a tree, although there was no need of it because he was motionless with his head hanging low and his trunk curling on the ground. He was upset and dejected. Paragraph 2. In this paragraph, we come to know that he was brought to the orphanage just 1 month before by the villagers, who found him alone. He was in a very poor condition as there was nobody to look after him. No one knew about his mother. They were not sure whether she was alive or not. They were also thinking that the herd had lost their kids. Whatever it was, the baby elephant was in a miserable condition. Paragraph 3, and this is the last paragraph. In this paragraph, the baby elephant was taken to the river where the other young elephants were playing with the water, but it couldn't make him happy. He was still upset. But 10 months later, the scene had changed. The baby elephant, who was the picture of unhappiness, now was the well-fed and happy elephant. He was yelling, running and splashing water. He was very happy with his new life and friends. He was no more sad now. In fact, he was the happiest elephant among all young elephants. This is how he found a new life. Okay, look at the questions at page 22. Question number 1 is, explain how the baby elephant's behavior shows that he was distressed. You can find the answer in paragraph 1. Question number 2. Why was the elephant's body yellowed when he was found? You can find the answer to this question in paragraph 2. Question 3. What suggestions does the writer make about what might have happened to his mother? You can also find the answer to this question in paragraph 2. Question number 4. In what ways had the elephant changed 10 months later? And you can find the answer to this question in paragraph 3. Question number 5. What adjective would you use to describe the atmosphere of the text? Okay, think about it. It could be a picture of happiness or a picture of misery and dejection. Okay, there are two options for you. Think and choose the right option. Picture of happiness or picture of misery and dejection. Okay, and student, do keep this thing in mind that all is well that ends well. Okay, move to the next page. Page number 23, vocabulary. Part 1. Write down the words in the text which have the meanings of the following words and phrases. There are 5 words. First one is gloomy depression. The meaning of this is dejection. Second is abundant and the meaning is deserted. Third one is uncared for, meaning neglected. Number 4 is mourning and the meaning is grieving. And the last one is nuzzle up to and the meaning is nuzzle. Okay, part 2 and 3. Part 2, mourning and mourning are homophones, words spelt differently with different meanings but with the same sound. Write 2 sentences using these 2 words. Trunk and trunk are homophones and these are the words spelled and sounding the same but with different meanings. Okay, write 2 sentences using these 2 words. Okay, you will do it yourself. Use your dictionary, find the meaning of these words and make sentences. Okay, come to the next page, page 24 and 25, and we are going to read the second text, Candy Pereira. This text has 5 paragraphs. Let's read paragraph 1. Candy Pereira, also known as the Festival of the Tooth. It is held in July and August in Kandy, Sri Lanka. This secret procession is held annually to pay homage to the secret tooth relic of Lord Buddha, which is housed at Sri Dalada Merigawa in Kandy for over 400 years. Paragraph 2. In this paragraph, we are told that the king was the guardian of this secret historical object. According to the old custom of Raja Kerya, he gave lands and holy shrine to people for specific duties. One of these was the dancing, drumming, and torch bearing of the procession. Another duty was to supply flowers for daily puja, and the third one was cultivating paddy fields for the daily offering of rice at the holy shrines. Nowadays, tourists from all over the world also come to see it. It begins at the full moon at a time prescribed good by the astrologer and continues every evening for 11 days. Paragraph 3. In the procession, they prayed God for rain, fertility, and successful crops. In Sri Lanka, as the elephants are a cultural symbol of fertility, so they are also participated in the parade. They travelled long distances to reach Kandy for the procession. They are decorated with brilliant covering stitched with mirrors in rich colors. Almost every part of elephant is covered in these decorated clothes. Only their eyes are visible. Paragraph 4. In this paragraph, we come to know that the procession starts with a ear-shattering sound of a stick. Men in white dress holding sticks are the flag bearers. Beautifully dressed elephants shining in the firelight. The drummers beating a frantic rhythm. There were also horn blowers and dancers who were dancing with their flashing anklets, bracelets and necklaces. Elephants link their trunks and sway to the rhythm of urgent beating of the drum. Nothing can disturb their crazy movement, not even the intense heat and noise around them. Paragraph 5. This is the last paragraph. In this paragraph, we are told that elephants are much regarded in Sri Lanka, so they are essential part of this procession. The procession is over when the gods of every shrine have been honored, and with this, elephants go back to their villages for the routine work. Okay, now move on to the questions. There are 5 questions. The questions are: question number 1 is, what was involved in the ancient culture of Raja Kerala? Paragraph 2, you can find the answer. Question 2, why do elephants have an important role in the Candy Parada? You can find the answer in paragraph 3. Question number 3, write down 3 nouns which are used for the fabrics which decorate the elephants. And the nouns are drapes and coverings. Okay. Write down, question 4, write down 3 phrases which convey the effect of light during the parada. You can find the answer to this question in paragraph 4. And question 5, describe the various sounds that can be heard during the parada. From paragraph 4, again, you can find the answer to the question. Okay, dear students, listen to the lecture again and read the text carefully and write the answers in to the question in your notebook. This is your homework. Okay, let's start our second topic. And the topic is number of nouns. Dear students, nouns have different form to show whether they mean one object or more than one object. Noun that stand for only one is said to be singular number, and the nouns that stand for more than one in the plural number. There are several ways of changing nouns in the singular into nouns in the plural number. Okay, I am telling you some rules. Rule number 1, the union way is by adding s to the singular, e.g. for example, flower, flowers, dog, dogs, girl, girls, etc. Rule 2, words ending in ch, sh, ss, o, x, etc. have es added to form plural. For example, church, churches, bush, bushes, hero, heroes, box, boxes, etc. Rule 3, words ending in y have the y changed to I before es, like baby, 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 babies, country, countries, fly, flies, etc. But if there is a vowel before y, then just add s to make plural. For example, boy, boy. There is a vowel before y, so we will just add s to make plural form of boy, boys. Monkey, monkeys. Day, days. Rule 4, several nouns have the words changed to form the plural. For example, man, man, men, men, tooth, tooth, tweeth, teeth, mouse, mouse, mice, mice, fwt, foot, fwt, feet, etc. Rule 5, some nouns have the same form of both singular and plural. For example, sheep, deer, dozen, vacation, etc. Rule number 6, in compound words only the principal word is changed from singular to plural. For example, son-in-law. Here the principal word is son, so we'll write sons-in-law. And the second one, maid servant. Here the principal word is servant. We'll write maid servants, etc. Rule number 7. Usually, when a word ends in F and FE, we change the F to V and add ES or S to make it plural. For example, calf, calves, knife, knives, shelf, shelves, thief, thieves. There are some other words we have to just add S to a to these words that ends in F, F, E and double F. The words are surf, giraffe, cliff, believe, save, chef, ref. Okay, now just add S to make plural form of these words. Okay, rule number 8. Some nouns cannot be used in the singular numbers. For example, scissors, spectacles, gallows, measles, etc. I hope it is clear to you now. Okay, now open your Scientific English Grammar Part 3 at page 13 and do the exercises Part 1 and 2 in your notebook. It is your homework. That's all for today. Have a nice day. Allah Hafiz.